Hey everyone, welcome to this tutorial video. It's been a while since the last one. This one came about simply because I uploaded a new environment to Open3D Lab, which is a rip of a Yakuza stage, like a short level that's in a cutscene. And I wanted to show kind of how I put it together, the tools I used to take it from the game, put it in Blender, and make some fancy renders out of it. So this is a scene that only shows up for like a short cutscene for like a few for maybe half a minute to a minute. It's the assets generally in the Yakuza games are relatively low res in terms of texture resolution, polygon resolution. So that's why you can see, if you look at the at some of these round corners, especially on the lamp here, you see the polygon resolution is not too great. But the thing is, when you're rendering a scene, you don't really see it. This is rendered with cycles. So you want to start with finding where you've installed your Yakuza game, basically in your Steam Apps folder generally. And then you go to the runtime folder, media. And this is where most of the game data is. So I've chosen Yakuza Like a Dragon, which is a great game. You should check it out. You can see that the file extensions for all these files, especially also in the stage directory, you can see all these stages are .par. This is the archive format, the packaging format that the Yakuza games generally use. So we cannot import these straight into Blender. We have to unpack them first. So first thing you want to get is the par manager, which is a command line tool for extracting the Yakuza par files. Go to releases and just grab whichever one is for your platform. So in this, you can unpack it with WinZip or whatever, or WinRAR. I'm just going to unpack it and move it to the Yakuza folder. Then I'm going to open a terminal window in this folder. Now, if you're not familiar with how the terminal generally works, take a computer course. I'm not gonna explain that to you right now. You can see here it's already, because I've run this command before, I can run this command quickly, but I'm gonna go with a list command first. So basically, if you run the par tool without any options, you'll see it prints a helpful kind of instruction thing with the possible commands. I did not specify a command, so I'm going to go with list. And then I'm going to look for what to put there. You're probably looking for a specific stage through the stages. And if I want to, right now I got the soap land pre-selected. Let's see, where is it? It's here. Yeah, this one. So you can list the contents. And basically what it will show is all the files that are in this par file, or that are referenced in a common kind of file that contains all the data. This is probably more relevant if you're into the more nitty-gritty stuff, but you can see, okay, we're getting like textures, the DDS files, those are textures. And if we then go with extract with the dash R, which is recursive, so if the main par file references a different par file, it will basically also extract those files from the reference par files. And then we select an output folder. So let's, for this exercise, try a different par file. I'm gonna go with this one. I have no idea what it is. We got a bunch of different texture files again. So when I do the dash H thing, what I intended to do there was to print a help prompt like this, but it just prints it also when you make a mistake in the command. So this is actually what I wanted, but you can see dash R extract nested par files, the archive itself, that's the first parameter, so that's the in this case the ST prison exit, and then the path to extract is the second parameter. So we're gonna quickly make this prison exit. I'm gonna copy it and then put it here. And what it will then do is it's gonna output all the files to that directory, and it's gonna preserve kind of directory structure in a way. So here it's gonna show what it's extracted. It's pretty fast. So just looking through these, the GMD files are the ones that are of note to us, because the GMD files are the actual meshes, like the models that we want to be importing. So with that, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up Blender. So before proceeding, you're gonna need this add-on, YKGMD.io. This is an add-on for Blender that allows you to import GMD files. At the time of making this video, there is a problem with this add-on, because Blender changed the Python API method. And that means the add-on is currently, at least the version that's under releases, is only compatible with Blender 4.2. So 4.3, 4.4, 4.5 are unfortunately not compatible. The author has created a bug fix that has already been added, but the release has not been updated yet. If there is a newer release for your Blender version, make sure to download that. For now, we're just gonna grab the zip file and open up Blender 4.2.1, which is the version that I have right now. But anyway, you can see I don't have it installed here, so I'm gonna put it in the folder. I'm gonna download. So we're gonna install this add-on, and there it is. So with the add-on installed, we have 4 new options: 2 for skinned and 2 for unskinned. The difference, modeling and animation. Not sure what the difference is. I could look it up, but I've just used modeling so far. So I'm just going to use the unskinned version. Select the directory where all our GMD files are. GMD files are the mesh files, just to reiterate. And here you can see all of them selected, and I'm going to import them. And before I import them, I'm going to quickly open up the console, so that we can monitor any progress as Blender freezes while it's importing. So as it's running, it's also trying to import the DDS textures. The DDS textures we'll have to address separately in a bit, but looks to be done. Here we have the prison exit from the scene where Ichiban gets out of prison after, like, I don't know, fucking 18 years. So yeah, it looks pretty good. Structure of this import is a bit messy. You can probably tweak the import options if you want. But what we want to do now is I'm going to show you the material preview. Again, Blender's going to freeze because it's going to try and recalculate all the shaders for the materials. This may take some time. It's also at this time going to load, or attempt to load, the DDS textures, which is gonna fail because Blender does not actually support DDS files properly. DDS is a direct draw surface, so that's a texture type that's specifically created for graphics processing, for this kind of thing in a game engine, real-time graphics. And yes, as you can see, all the textures have failed to load. So we're gonna head over to shading. We're gonna see like what it's done actually. As you can see, Neo Yakuza shader. This is the shader that the add-on uses, and it references these DDS textures, which it can't load. We will actually try and find these. So if we look at, we copy the file name and we look in our prison exit and we type it into search, we can see that this file exists and it previews in Explorer, but it's of course not loading in Blender. First, what we're gonna do is we're gonna convert our DDS textures, and we're gonna use a tool provided by Microsoft, because DDS is like a Microsoft kind of thing. So DDS can be easily converted using like the DDS plugin for Photoshop. But if you don't have Photoshop, the options for GIMP and other tools are not very accessible. In the past, I've used my own DDS Clobber tool, but that's proven very unreliable for people. So I'm gonna show you how to use an official tool made by a real company. So DexConf is like a command line tool. It allows you to convert DDS textures to basically any other format. What you're gonna do is you're gonna go to the GitHub page, go to releases, and here you can find a bunch of exe files. Textconf.exe is the one you want, download it. So once again, I've put textconf in the Yakuza directory, so it's easy to find. I'm gonna open a terminal window. I'm gonna start typing textconf. And here you can see that it's already trying to autocomplete what I've done before. Let's walk through some of these command line flags. I'm using rkeep, which is recursive and keeps the directory structure. Then what we're gonna do, since we look at the prison exit, you can see all these folders with that end in underscore text dot par. Those are the texture archives that we've extracted. They contain the DDS files, the textures that we want to convert. So there's 18 of these. I'm just gonna copy this path, put it between quotes since there are spaces in the directory names. Then I'm gonna end it with a slash and then a asterisk, and this basically signals that it should go through all these folders, that it should go through all these folders looking for any DDS files. So next we have -m1, which should strip the mipmaps. Don't worry about that, it's not important. Then we do -format, so -ft. We set the file to png, and then f actually is like the internal format that we specify. This is the one that worked for me. This includes the alpha channel and unorm. No idea what it means. Could look it up, don't care. -o then specifies our output directory, which is gonna be the same as our input directory. So then we hit enter, and it's gonna go through all the DDS files and convert them to PNG. If you get an error running this command, you probably made a mistake in specifying the options. So it seems to be done. And now we check and we see that it has in fact created PNG versions. So one of the annoying things that this plugin does is it tries to scan for the DDS files, but ends up not properly picking up on the path. It sets a source to generate it, which is kind of annoying. So even if we update the path manually, it's gonna not immediately work. And it's actually a lot of work to relabel it for all of these different objects and materials. So for now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use a script. Just gonna paste it in, change the root directory, change the root directory to the path that it's gonna have to search in, quickly take a gander at the console, and do a dry run first, and that way we can see which ones it's gonna update. And it's gonna update like 700 textures, and now it's gonna actually do the work. And there we go. So now we're moving to the shading tab, and it's already hanging Blender because it's gonna recalculate all the shaders, which is probably also again not gonna work because all of these textures are still set to generated. So I have another script that should fix that too. I'm gonna actually combine these and post them in the video description so you can use these to your advantage if you want. Boom, console output. Now it should have updated everything, and if we toggle to shading now, we shall see that all the texture nodes have been updated to reference these files, and then all the materials and shaders should reload, recalculate, and there we go. Now we see it's updated to single image, and it's actually pretty snazzy already. Now with the file saved, I'm gonna quickly toggle over to cycles and on the GPU, of course, because I'm not a peasant. And now the 4090 is at work, and it's already doing a pretty good job at doing a first render of this thing. But it's pretty dark, so I'm gonna go over to world, set the, there we go. Okay, pretty good. Pretty good. So these are all different parts of the road. Interesting. So this is a good starting point for any work you want to be doing. Materials aren't perfect, but they're pretty good. For the soapland, I did not actually have to modify much. You can see the way they allocate texture resolution is a bit odd at times, but that might be just to do with like what's on screen and what isn't. I imagine they use a lot of these scenes. This scene especially is used in cutscenes, so it's not really gonna be super high resolution everywhere. Can probably tell that this part is only there for the background, and especially as you get like further away. Well, not even that. Like especially as you look at some of these buildings, they're not super like detailed. Like this is they're using very few polygons, and they're making the texture go a long way. This is also why Japanese architecture is very well suited for this kind of stuff, because it's very, very simple, very boxy, very optimized, let's say. But you do get some fun fun areas. Oh, what's this? Might also be that there's some low resolution or like some shadow geometry or some collision geometry there. Not sure what this is for, but it's unshaded, so I'm assuming it's some kind of yeah, so this is a module of the house. You see again lots of low poly structures, easy to render, very well optimized. So if you then wanna shoot your scene, let's add a camera loop. Gonna make it wide rendered. And then you can look at like ways to find materials that are lights and stuff, then use emissive materials like I did with my the soap lamp rip. Just notice that the cables are not attached to anything. So there might be some models that are not imported properly, but you can probably find them in the GMD folder or in any of the other subdirectories. Part of the model. But this is just an example. It should get you some of the way into extracting some of these files, and they are useful. Like the Yakuza games are very aesthetic. They capture Japan really well. So I really recommend checking them out and making cool stuff. Make sure to upload what you make to Open3D Lab. And yeah, if you have any questions, check the Discord and support me on Patreon. Bye bye. Thank you.